I was in Chicago for a big press event for what is anticipated as the big holiday movie. How about when the bad moms get together for Christmas? Twist here is the bad moms are joined for the holidays by their own moms. We'll get to Susan Sarandon, Christine Baranski, and Cheryl Hines later. But now, leading ladies, Mila Kunis, Kristen Bell, Katherine Hahn, they're all together. They're doing a ton of press. Quite a bit. You know, your muscles get sore and tight. But Kristen doesn't complain. She helps her co-stars, as I discovered. All right, so you're massaging your ladies.
Yeah.
But apparently Mila has a much bigger knot.
No, well, Catherine's back is fused.
Right.
Completely fused. It's just, right.
And that's
it
the
is.
Center. And Mila has more shoulder issues.
I see.
So I like to get in there and just like dig deep on those little marbles in there.
Right.
But Catherine's
scapulas French braid of muscles
are
down
fused to her spine.
So, I mean, you've had great Rick success Wall. Here in show business, but owning a Massage Envy franchise, would that be the way
it's
for
a possibility? Because
really?
I'll tell you something, it is one of my love languages.
Right.
I love touch. Yeah. I'm always like putting my hands on people.
I love the phrase love language.
Yeah, and I'm kind of good at it. Like I can sense where there's like angry little muscles, and I just like it. It's nice to have something that people are like, oh, that when you do that, I'm happy. I'm like, yeah.
Okay, I mean this in the least forward way. Can I lean my arm in? Would
yes,
you mind?
Of course.
Okay, if you don't mind.
Oh, you're gonna have you not? Yeah. Oh, watch this.
What do you?
Oh my God.
No, it's no jokes.
We know. We know.
It's magic.
We know. Sam. Don't be dramatic or patronizing.
No, because some people are schooled and some people have the touch, and you have the touch.
She has
the touch.
Thank you. No. I do like it. I mean, I do. I'm just going to finish. I'm going to round you out a little bit. I'm not going to do like two of your fingers and have you not be able to type them.
Sam, you didn't know this was a full service.
Yeah. No.
Junket, did you?
We're here.
And you know, Mila Kunis is a spokesperson, I guess, does all those commercials for Jim Beam, the bourbon whiskey or whatever.
Yeah, in the
so
factory.
So you walked into your hotel room.
Yeah.
And in, like, hello, here's a huge bottle of liquor and a note from her.
Oh.
Which, given the behavior of most of my colleagues, ensures this movie may be the most well-reviewed film ever.
Say Christmas back. Gifts, no more perfect decorations, no more perfect anything.
You're gonna get the best reviews of any movie of all time ever because of the bottle of liquor you put in every person's room. when these reviews come in and it's like Lawrence of Olivier, Godfather 2, Bad Mom's
Christmas.
It's totally because you know it. It's the smartest marketing thing. I thought the Price is Right thing was good. This is bad.
Such kind eyes.
Put a baby in me, Santa number two!
What about Bad Mom's Passover? Bad Mom's, like,
Bad Mom's Passover.
Don't you think Bad Mom's Passover would be great?
Yes. Yes, the brisket is gonna be, there's a whole storyline about that brisket. It's gonna happen.
Do you make a brisket?
Yeah, of course.
And do you make a good brisket or bad brisket?
I make an unbelievable brisket.
Really, that's a pretty big claim.
I love brisket.
I make,
it's brisket.
Oh, but it's like slowly cooked, you know.
It's some, like, Jewish-ish meat, yes.
You put in, I mean, beef. Put it in the oven.
I don't know
mine
what
is
that means.
In there
that's
for hours. I mean, probably like 6 hours.
That means
hours.
It's great if it's slow cooked.
Oh,
right?
It's so slow cooked. Good. It's also covered in mounds and mounds of onions, which doesn't sound like it would be delicious, but the onions produce like a really sweet juice, and it makes the brisket taste.
God, the way you describe it is, I am salivating right now.
It's so good.
It sounds so good.
It's wonderful.
I want brisket.
I can honestly say I will make a brisket and invite you ladies over for Passover next year.
Well, wait, a key?
I don't even eat meat.
Sam, you're right.
She doesn't even eat meat.
I don't even eat meat.
They're similar.
Oh, Sam, you brought it up and then you weren't invited.
I think she invited me at the end.
You know what? She can come here and bring us brisket and Jim Beam.